Hello everyone, welcome back. Miss Luann here, ready to start our day and learn something exciting from God's Word. We have a really fun story today. Again, we're learning about Moses and what happened with Moses and the Israelites. Well, in the Bible, there are lots of stories about real people and real things that happen, and they are all true. Our story today takes place in the book of Exodus. So let's begin. Are you ready? Get your comfortable place. Let's get started. God gave the Ten Commandments. Moses and the Israelites had escaped from Egypt. They came to Mount Sinai and they set up camp. God wanted to make a covenant or a special agreement with his people. So Moses went up the mountain. God told Moses, "Tell the Israelites this message. If you listen carefully to me and keep my commandments, you will be my people." Moses told the people what God said. The Israelites said, "We'll do everything God said." Moses went back up the mountain. God told Moses, "I'm going to come in a thick cloud. I want the people to hear me speak to you so that they will believe you." Moses got the people ready. God came down the mountain in a fire and smoke covered the mountain. God said, "I am the Lord your God. I brought you out of the land of Egypt." Then God gave Moses the Ten Commandments. The first four commandments told the Israelites how to have a right relationship with God. They were, "Do not have other gods besides me. Do not make an idol for yourself. Do not misuse the name of the Lord your God. Remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy." Then, the last six commandments told the Israelites how to have a right relationship with each other, with other people. So first, honor your father and mother. Do not murder. Keep your marriage promises. Do not steal. Do not lie. Do not want what belongs to someone else. Moses stayed on the mountain for many days. God gave Moses more laws. When God was finished speaking to Moses, he gave Moses two stone tablets God had written on the tablets with his own finger. Wow. The people actually got to hear God's own voice coming from the smoky cloud. So the people were set up in a camp because they're out wandering in the wilderness. They came to Mount Sinai. I don't really have a mountain here, but we can make a pretend mountain, perhaps. It was a very big mountain. So that could be our Mount Sinai where Moses had to go. He went up and God told Moses that he was going to appear in a cloud. So first came down in a fire. And then the smoke filled everything, and everything was covered by a thick cloud. And God spoke to the people and gave them, how many commandments were there? Ten commandments. The first four talked about how to have a good relationship with God, and the next six told about how we could have a good relationship with each other. And then, after he spent a lot of time with Moses, he wrote the commandments on stone tablets. With his own finger. And Moses took those down to show them to the people. He was up there for a long, long time, many days. Mount Sinai, we'll put that over here. So the people, it was important for them to worship God. What is worship? Worship is celebrating the greatness of God. The people got to hear, they got to hear God's great voice speaking. Here's our verse for the month. Psalm 95:6. Let's say it together. Come, let's worship and bow down. Let's kneel before the Lord our Maker. Psalm 95:6. Let's do it one more time. Ready? Come, let's worship and bow down. Let's kneel before the Lord our Maker. Psalm 95:6. And we can worship God too. For our craft, I thought we could make our own 10 commandments. So how many commandments are there? 10. So I have this cut out here. Okay, so the first four are about our relationship with God. You can see the little boy here is praying. We could perhaps cut this out to make it look more like the tablets that I just showed you, the stone ones. So use your safety scissors to cut out a shape like this. Then the other six are about having a good relationship with each other. In the picture, you can see these children being kind after this young boy and helping him out. That's one thing God wants us to do. He wants us to be his hands and feet and his kind words to other people. So this one says love others. The other one said love God. This one says love others. That's what God wants us to do. He wants us to love him first and then love everybody else. So we have our numbers right here, 1 to 10, and you can color them after you glue them on. So the first 4 are about God's love, and the second 6 are about our love for each other. Just a little bit of glue is all it takes. Add them to our tablet. You can do that. You can make your own little ones. If you're not in class right now working on this, if you're at church with us, your teacher will give it to you and you can do it together. So after you get all of your numbers on, then you can color them, and then we'll be able to join them together, just like the big tablet. We'll need our tape, and of course, you can color it to make it look even better. We'll tape our 2 tablets together, so it'll look just like the ones that I showed you, the stone ones. So you can color these 2 pictures, color the numbers if you want to, and there's your 10 commandments, so you can help remember. But what were the 10 commandments? Let's review them one more time because it's a lot to remember. So, do not have other gods beside me. That was the first one. Do not make an idol for yourself. Do not misuse the name of the Lord your God. Remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. Now, the other ones are about loving other people. Honor your father and mother. Do not murder. Keep your marriage promises. Do not steal. Do not lie. Do not want what belongs to someone else. So those are the 10 commandments that God wants us to keep. We can also make some 10 commandment snack. Are you with me on that one? We're going to need some graham crackers because that's going to be our tablets. And then we're going to use some whipped cream, which is always delicious, or you can use some frosting. I happen to have chocolate right now. You can use chocolate or vanilla. And then we'll need something to put on it. We have to put 10 of something on it to remember the 10 commandments. So we can either have 10 raisins or my personal favorite, 10 chocolate chips. Are you ready to get started? Got all our supplies here. Let's move Mount Sinai out of the way. Okay, we're gonna need a plastic knife, a paper plate, and 2. How many graham crackers do you think we'll need? 2, right? Because they were 2 tablets. So let's pull these out of here. Let's grab 2 graham crackers. You can use 2 big ones, or you can break one in half and have 2 smaller ones. It's up to you. So these kind of look like 2 stone tablets, don't they? Okay, so I'm gonna start. Let's see if my frosting is working. Oh, it looks delicious. I'm gonna just stir it up. Use your knife. And then the good part about this, when you finish this craft, you can eat it. So we're putting some frosting on our tablets. This one is gonna be chocolate because that's the kind of frosting I had in the refrigerator at home. Or we could use our whipped cream. Let me show you how that one would work so you could just see which one you would like better. What do you think? Which one do you think you'd like? So we could break this in half and make it into 2 tablets, and this one can be broken into 2 tablets. Then we can add 10 of something. So 10 chocolate chips. Let's count together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's the 6 about loving other people. And 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the 4 about loving God the most. You can also put some raisins on this one. And we're also going to do 10 again because that's how many commandments we have. Are you ready? Okay, so love God the most. So 4 for that one. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then to love others. How are we going to love others? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. All right. That is our 10 commandments craft. What do you think? You think it's a good idea? So there's our 2 tablets, and there's our 2 other tablets. So enjoy eating your Ten Commandment craft. I know I will. That's about all I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed learning about how God came down and spoke to the people and told them how he wanted them to obey and to behave. And he wants us to do the same thing too. So have a wonderful day. Enjoy spending time with your family. Remember to worship God and love God. Jesus loves you, and so do I. Till next time.
Now, family, may the Lord bless you and protect you. May his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May he look on you with favor and give you his sweet peace. You are loved.